Hey guys, and welcome to the Superfood Junkie, where we make three healthy and delicious meals a day for 5 days, all in about 2 hours. This week, we're making turkey and egg white wraps for breakfast, a cilantro lime shrimp with veggies and quinoa for lunch, and braised chicken with Brussels sprouts and yams for dinner. For ingredients, I start with a package of sliced turkey breasts. This one comes from Costco, has no preservatives, and is actually sliced from turkey breast. A package of flat-out 100-calorie multigrain wraps, but you can use any kind of tortilla. I have a medley of leafy super greens, which includes spinach, kale, and chard, but if you can't find this, you can just use spinach. 1 carton of egg whites, 1 onion, 5 avocados, which will be used in breakfast and lunch, 1 bunch of cilantro, 1.5 pounds of peeled and deveined shrimp, 2 lemons, 2 yellow zucchini, 2 limes, 2 Italian squash, a bag of quinoa, 2 pounds of Brussels sprouts, 1.5 pounds of chicken breast, 1.5 pounds of yams, and about 4 Roma tomatoes. So let's begin our food prep. You'll see here we're starting at 5:30. The first thing I'm going to do is preheat my oven to 450 degrees. Next, we're going to prep all of our vegetables first. Make sure you wash and clean all of the vegetables before you even start chopping. For the Brussels sprouts, I cut off the ends and then cut them in half. I want to make sure they're bite-sized pieces. I also remove any outer leaves that may look bruised or damaged. Brussels sprouts are a great superfood because they're packed with plenty of essential vitamins like A, C, and K. They help lower the risk of cancer and heart disease. They boost your immune system. And they're also high in fiber, which aids in digestion. For the zucchini and squash, I just want to give them a simple chop. I start by cutting off the tops and bottoms and slicing them in half lengthwise. I then chop them into about 1/4 inch width piece, but they don't have to be perfect. If you don't like zucchini and squash, substitute with your favorite green vegetable like broccoli or asparagus. Next, I'm going to give the cilantro a rough chop. If you're not comfortable doing this, go ahead and pulse it a few times in your food processor or blender. Cilantro is another great superfood. It helps lower your bad cholesterol, lower your blood sugar, and also aids in digestion and helps stomach problems. When slicing an onion, I begin by cutting off one end and slicing the onion in half through the other end. This will keep the onion together while you're slicing it. Peel off the outer layers and cut the onion into thin slices. If onions make you cry, place the onion in the fridge to chill for about 1 hour. This will prevent any tears while chopping. Next, wrap your yams in foil to help them cook more evenly in the oven. As a superfood, these are high in vitamins B6, C, and D, as well as iron. These also help you reduce stress and relax. Next, do a rough chop on the tomatoes and put them in a food processor or blender. Add 1/4 cup of balsamic vinegar and give it a rough blend. Tomatoes are known to help fight the aging process, aid in weight loss, and also prevent certain types of cancers. Now that we're done with prepping the vegetables, I can move on to the chicken. Food safety is important when you're handling any kind of raw protein. As you can see here, I've chosen to wear rubber gloves. Once I'm done preparing the chicken, I will discard these gloves and I will not use this cutting board and knife on any other food prep for this meal. This package of chicken was about 2.5 pounds. For this meal prep, I only need about 1.5 pounds. My portion size is typically about 4 to 5 ounces of any kind of protein. There were 4 chicken breasts in this package. After doing the math, I will need about 2.5 breasts. To help you figure out your portions, here's some simple math. 1 pound equals 16 ounces. So this package of 2.5 pounds equaled about 40 ounces. With 4 chicken breasts in the package, they were about 10 ounces each. Cutting them in half gave me about 5 ounces. Now season your chicken with some salt and pepper. As you can see, I removed my gloves and I'm now using tongs to flip the chicken over. Set your chicken aside. Next, take your zucchini and squash and stir in about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Here I have 1/4 cup and used half of that, so that's 1/8 cup. 1/4 cup equals 4 tablespoons. 1/8 cup equals 2 tablespoons. Next, I also added 2 tablespoons of olive oil to my Brussels sprouts. I also added 2 tablespoons of balsamic vinegar and gave it a toss. While tossing, I noticed I needed a little bit more olive oil, so I added 2 more tablespoons. Next, grab 2 baking trays. For easy cleanup, I like to line my pans with foil. Next, pour out the Brussels sprouts into this pan. Make sure you get a nice, even layer. Season with salt and pepper. Take your second baking tray and also line that with foil. Pour the mixture of zucchini and squash onto this tray. Make sure you get an even layer and season with salt and pepper. Now we get to finally start cooking. In your preheated oven, place the Brussels sprouts on the top rack and your zucchini and squash on the bottom rack. Wherever you have space, place the yams. The zucchini and squash will take 20 to 30 minutes, while the Brussels sprouts and yams will take about 45 minutes to an hour. In a small saucepan, add 1 cup of dry quinoa and 2 cups of water. Turn on the stove to medium-high heat and cover with lid. We're going to wait for this to boil. With your saute pan, turn the stove up to high and add 1 tablespoon of olive oil. When the oil is hot, add your onions and cook until they become soft and translucent. Next, I'll add the chicken on top of the onions. I'm going to cook them for a few minutes on each side until they begin to brown. I check on the quinoa and notice it's about to boil. I move it to the back burner so I can make space to cook the shrimp. I turn the burner to high and add about 1 tablespoon of olive oil to heat up. While that pan is heating up, I'm going to add my mixture of tomatoes and balsamic vinegar to my chicken. Give the chicken a good stir to incorporate the tomatoes and balsamic vinegar. By now, your pan should be warm enough to add the shrimp. Season it with salt and pepper. Shrimp only takes a few minutes to cook. Now I'm going to reach into my spice drawer and grab the Italian seasoning. Italian seasoning is great because it's a blend of other spices, so I'm going to add about 1 tablespoon. If you don't have Italian seasoning, you can add a mixture of 1 teaspoon basil, 1 teaspoon oregano, and 1 teaspoon parsley. I'll also add about 1 tablespoon of garlic, which is entirely optional. I keep a stash of minced garlic in my fridge. I buy a big bag of organic garlic cloves from Costco, mix it up in my food processor, and store it in a jar with some olive oil. Then it's ready for use at any time. Stir up your shrimp so it cooks evenly on both sides. Here, I check on the quinoa and notice that it's boiling. I remove the lid and let it continue to boil until there's almost no more liquid left. Quinoa is a super grain that's naturally gluten-free, high in fiber, and filled with protein. It's high in iron and magnesium, which helps with migraines, cardiovascular disease, and diabetes. As I'm cooking my shrimp, I make sure to check on the chicken. It's starting to simmer, so I'm going to put the lid on and lower the heat to medium-low and let it continue to simmer. I know my shrimp is cooked when it's turned all pink and is no longer translucent. Next, I grab the limes and squeeze 1/2 lime to 1 whole lime into the shrimp, depending on your liking. Make sure you give it a good stir. Next, grab about half of the chopped cilantro and add it to the shrimp. Again, give it a good stir. Next, squeeze lime juice into the quinoa, either half a lime or one whole lime, depending on your liking. By now, your shrimp and quinoa are almost done. Turn the heat off on the shrimp. Take a look at the quinoa and notice that there's almost no more liquid and it's making little bubbles. Place the lid on. Remove the quinoa and shrimp off of the heat. Now it's time to check on your Brussels sprouts. Remove them from the oven and give them a good stir. We want to make sure these caramelize all over. Place it back in the oven. Next, check on your zucchini and squash. These are almost done, but give it a good little stir and put it back in the oven for a few more minutes. Don't forget to check on your chicken. Next, grab a small nonstick pan and place it on medium heat. Spray the pan with some cooking spray and pour in about half a cup of egg whites. What we're basically making are egg white pancakes for our wraps. With the pan on medium heat, I'm going to add a lid so that it cooks the top and bottom evenly. Check your chicken again, and this time taste for seasoning. If you need to add more salt and pepper, add it now. The egg whites are going to cook pretty quickly. What I'm looking for is a dry top before I can flip it over. With my spatula, I'm going to pop any of the air bubbles in the egg whites. Once the eggs are no longer runny, I can flip this over. Loosen the sides and flip it over. When it's done, place the egg white pancake on a platter. Repeat this 4 more times. During the second time, I pull the zucchini out of the oven and set those aside. At this time, the chicken is also done. Turn off the burner and remove the pan from the heat. During the last egg white pancake, I check on the Brussels sprouts and notice that they're ready. I grab a lemon and squeeze it over the Brussels sprouts. I then set it aside to cool. You can also remove the yams from the oven and turn it off. After I've let the quinoa rest for about 15 minutes, I add the remainder of the cilantro, leaving behind about a quarter cup for garnish. Stir well. Add some salt and pepper and make sure you taste for seasoning. We're finally done cooking. When we started it was 5:30 and now it's almost 7:15. All we have left to do is to package up our meals. Make sure when you meal prep, all of your containers are cleaned and ready to go for when you're done cooking. I use a variety of containers, some Ziploc, some Rubbermaid, and some Sistema. To assemble your breakfast, layer your wrap, egg white, turkey, half an avocado, and a handful of greens. Remember to save the other half of your avocado for lunch. Avocados are a great source of healthy fats, but they're also full of potassium, fiber, and other vitamins. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button. If you want to see more, make sure you subscribe. And if there's something you want to see in a future video, please leave a comment below. Thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you guys next time.